Good evening. Welcome to Mass at St. Robert's Parish. Placing Christ at the center of our lives challenges not only to love God, but also to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. As we join together in worship of a God who loves us, let us focus on the unity we share as children of God. Our gathering hymn is, "Come Christians, Join to Sing," which can be found in the Purple We Celebrate hymnal, number 910. Please stand as we begin our celebration with our pastor, Father Richard Serva.
Oh, Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded at the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also. For they could hear, speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing our responsorial song, "All the Ends of the Earth," which can be found on the yellow insert in the purple We Celebrate hymnal, number 9.
Oh,
We read it from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. And this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Bearer was here and was delighted,
really with the whole celebration, the Mass and the dinner afterwards and so forth. So it was just a wonderful celebration and a wonderful occasion to celebrate 125 years of faith, living out faith in the present with hope for the future. And the scripture readings that we hear for this sixth Sunday of Easter, the Easter season now is going to draw to a close shortly with the celebration of Pentecost. But before we get to Pentecost, we will celebrate the Holy Day this week, the Ascension of the Lord. Ascension Thursday this week, which is a holy day of obligation. And Jesus is preparing his disciples for his departure from them before he is to be ascended back to the Father. He gives them the command, love one another as I have loved you. There is no greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends. And that, I think, is the important thing for all of us to reflect on as we place our faith in this person who is Jesus, this relationship that we have with the person. Our faith is grounded in Jesus Christ. Our faith is grounded in a person who is Jesus, and he calls us friends. Sometimes I think people go through life almost being like afraid of God. They see Jesus as somebody that's out there judging them all the time, and they never see him as their friend. And Jesus makes clear to the disciples, he makes clear to you and to me, you are my friends if you do what I command you. Love one another as I have loved you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain. This I command you. Love one another. And so as we listen to these scripture readings, and as the Easter season will be drawing to a close, it's a good reflection for all of us to reflect on the relationship that we have with Jesus, just like we have relationships with each other. We have a relationship with Jesus. Our faith is not grounded in a building. Our faith is not grounded in the institution of the church. Our faith is grounded in a relationship with the person that we are baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And so as we listen to these readings, let us reflect upon the relationship that we have with Jesus, and let us be faithful to what he commands us to do by loving him and loving one another. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe. who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Out of love for one another, we call to mind the needs of others, of all whom we love, and all whom we are called to love, as we seek God's bountiful grace.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer for the church, that we may be a sign of God's love to both members of our flock and those who are not, so that through our works of kindness and mercy, we may demonstrate the way we love one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That out of our love for those they serve, our leaders may work to bring justice and fairness to all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of friendship, which Jesus gave his disciples, that we may pass it on to those whom we love and treasure it always, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have suffered the loss of a child, and for those who are unable to have children, that they may be consoled, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Orthodox Christians who are celebrating Easter Sunday this weekend, and all of us who continue to celebrate the Easter season, that we may recognize the risen Christ in our midst as we serve one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special intention book near our cross, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the children in our parish who are receiving First Communion this weekend, that they may know God's loving guidance and strength in their lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in Christ, for Jack and Betty Delaney, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for others we would like to remember, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And as we begin this month of May, devoted to the Blessed Mother, let us pray through her intercession that these petitions be answered by her Son, as together we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Please join in singing our hymn during the preparation of the gifts, where charity and love prevail, which can be found in the purple we celebrate at home, number 862.
Yeah.
priest, the altar, and the Lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be
gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church. Spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, all the clergy, religious, and faithful people. Remember Jack and Betty Delaney. Also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Aloysius, St. Robert Bellarmine, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
You say, oh,
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be.
Thank you.
restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ. Increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord. And just a reminder, the holy day of obligation, Wednesday evening, Thursday, is the Ascension Thursday. And so check the bulletin for the schedule of Masses here and exaltation of the Holy Cross. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ. Have a great evening.
Please join us. Joy, which can be found in the purple we celebrate hymnal number 608.